different animal proteins have different nutritional densities. The difference between a grass-fed cow or a free-range chicken and an antibiotic-pumped cow and a factory chicken are tremendous. Avoid factory-farmed meat and fish. The most nutrient-rich proteins are from properly raised meat. Personally, I'm a massive fan of poultry, but the hormone-loaded chickens that are found in some commercial supermarkets are best avoided. If you can get your hands on organic and/or free-range chicken, you are going to get a much higher nutritional return. And this is very easy to do. You just need to ask your local butcher. In the case of fish, try to avoid farm fish that has been pumped full of colorings and opt for wild fish whenever possible. Again, your supermarket or local fishmonger should be able to tell you which fish is wild and which has been farmed. There's a frustrating paradox for those who eat farmed fish for their health, as the nutritional benefits of farmed fish are greatly decreased. Take omega-3 fatty acids, for example. Wild fish get their omega-3 from aquatic plants. Farmed fish, however, are often fed corn, soy, or other feedstuff that have little or no omega-3s. The unnatural high corn diet also means that some farmed fish accumulate unhealthy levels of the wrong fatty acids. The most concerning issue is that farmed fish are routinely dosed with antibiotics, which can then enter your body and cause all kinds of harm, not to mention slowing down any physical progress, such as losing body fat, building muscle, etc. Remember the famous quote, "You are what you eat"? You can probably extend this to, "You are also what your food eats." Eat the right meat and get more vitamin B12. Vitamin B12 is a water-soluble vitamin that keeps your nerves and blood cells healthy. It is responsible for the smooth functioning of several critical body processes. It is pretty easy to develop a vitamin B12 deficiency, the first symptom normally being chronic fatigue. Strict vegetarians or vegans, heavy drinkers and smokers are usually most susceptible to vitamin B12 deficiency.